Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I'll make apps. Now today, let's answer the question, are iOS developers going to die off? All right, so today I want to answer a question that came in a couple of days ago from Saif Mukaddam. Saif says, nice video, sir. I am an iOS developer and I want to ask you, are iOS developers will die because of Apple prices because everybody's preferring Android over iOS because of crazy prices? So, good question, Saif. Will iOS developers die out? To be honest with you, I don't think they will, right? We talk a lot about Android's market share over iOS. Like globally, Android has like nearly an 80% market share and iOS has only 20%. And when I tell people that, they're usually really surprised. In fact, I had a client call me just a few weeks ago and they wanted their app to be done in iOS only because most people have iPhones. And I was like, actually, most people have Androids. And he was really surprised by that. In fact, earlier this week, there was it was in the news that iPhone sales have fallen like 17% in the last quarter, which is unprecedented. They're starting to go down. However, I talked to a lot of iOS developers who only do iPhone and they're happy with it. They're making lots of money. They're doing really well. And so what I wanted to do today was talk about market share in terms of applications. So I throw this number out there a lot. There's only 20% market share for iOS. However, that statistic doesn't take in individual countries. So last time we did a video about this, we looked at StatCounter and the different market shares over time. I want to do that again today, but I want to look at specific countries. So in some countries, iOS has a preference. In some countries, it's Android. And as I've said before, and I still believe this, you make more money on iOS than you do on Android, but you get a lot more downloads on Android. So every month I make a lot more through Google Play than I do from the App Store. But if you were to break it down per user, I make a bit more on the App Store than I do on Google Play. So have a look at my screen here. Up here we have StatCounter, which is what we talked about before. So this is just looking at the last year. So, and this is a really good tool. I think you should explore it yourself. Take a look at what it looks like in your region, break it down. But here you can see we've got at the top, we've got the different market shares per operating system. We got Android was 74.85%. So it used to be a bit higher just a few months ago. In fact, if we look up here, we can see earlier in the year, we had 77%, 32%. It drops a little bit, goes back up. It's remained pretty consistent over the past year. And down here, we have iOS, which at the moment, we're at 22.94%. But you know, it pretty much stays the same. It was up to 24% in November, then December, and it keeps going. And then we have the other ones, KaiOS, which is, I think it's an open source OS. I looked it up. I'm not interested enough to developing for it. You used to get Windows over here with this 0.28%, right? But it's the two big ones that I'm always concerned with. We always do iPhone and Android applications, and of course cross-platform if we could do it, so we could serve both of them. But so you look at this, and if you're thinking about what technology to get into, you think, obviously, I'm going to be an Android developer. If I'm going to release an app, obviously, I'll just release it to Android. Why even bother with iOS? But this is very much the entire population. So the nice thing about StatCounter is you can go through and drill down on things. So if you go on Edit Chart Data, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the United States. Let's go to the United States, which is my biggest market. Even though I'm in the UK, the United States is the one that I get the most from. So if we look at the same chart, just looking at the United States of America, here you can see iOS is top with 52%, but just barely. We're looking nearly at an equal split. Well, not really an equal split. I mean, if you were voting, Apple would win. But you can see it's pretty much remained on top the whole time. And we talk about people who are going to be able to spend more money on in-app purchases. In my experience, the US spends more than, say, India or other countries. So we look at that, and we look at some other ones. If we look at the United Kingdom as well, the United Kingdom, we see a bit more of a split here where we can see it sort of crosses over a little bit, and we're seeing the big brands start to take over, right? And the Canada is the same, so we're talking about the more affluent countries or the countries with a lot more disposable income. Canada, say, alphabetical order. I'll learn it one of these days. So you can see Canada's kind of the same thing. We've got iOS on top here, and it's pretty much stays the same. If you're going to release to the Western world or to, well, if you're going to US, to English speaking world, iPhone is still something that's very valid. But it's at the point now where you should consider doing both of them if you're going to release an app at all, right? But let's have a look at some of the other countries. Let's have a look at India. And I'm just going to pick some at random, but I encourage you to go through and have a look at the stat counter tool. It's really easy to use. I'll include a link in the description, but you see India here, we've got 90% Android. iOS is only 2.75%, so we'd have a lot more handsets over there and everything would go. Let's look at, what other country should we look at? Let's look at Japan, which I haven't looked at this one earlier. So Japan is heavily iOS, so you know, this is something to consider when you're looking at this kind of stuff. When we talk about the 80% market share, nearly 80% market share that Android has, it would be very tempting to think that you could just ignore iOS. Like, I'm an Android developer, I don't need to worry about the iOS side of things, but I've talked to a lot of iOS developers who aren't interested in Android, even though they might have more users. And more users is good for ad revenue, but they might have more users, but they're not interested. They're not getting the same in-app purchases. They're not getting the same purchases as they do on Android, as they do on iPhone. So it's something to consider. So to answer your question, Saif, no, iOS developers are not dead. iOS developers are thriving. iOS developers are doing just fine. Thank you very much. If you ask, and like the ones that I talked to, they're good. Don't worry about us. We're good, right? We have problems with 4.3. They have problems with app approvals and everything, the same way we do with Google Play, but they're doing okay. So I think you'll be fine, Saif. Specialize in that. Get really, really good at it. So anyway, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again next time.